for morning rounds. It's warming up outside, which means time for the sunblock. There are many things that can go wrong when we are exposed to the sun. So helping us understand the differences is Katie Mitchell with Christie Clinic's Department of Dermatology. Hey, Katie, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Good. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Well, you know, virtually. We appreciate your time. So we're talking about the difference between heat rash, sunburn, and sun poisoning, right?
Yes.
Because there's a difference.
Yes, definitely. So heat rash is when our sweat ducts actually get occluded. And we often see this in infants, young children, but we can also see this in adults as well too. The result is basically this very fine red rash, occasionally itchy. You can have these little teeny tiny fluid filled blisters as well too. The best way to treat this, it's pretty easy. It's cool down. So get out of that hot environment, wear some loose clothing, doing things like that can help cool you down.
And I think many of us know what that sunburn feels like.
Yes, so the dreaded sunburn. So I've seen a little more of this within the past few days in clinic, but so basically it happens after too much UV exposure without sunscreen or sun protective clothing. Often it shows up a few hours after you're in the sun, and then you have this red rash, which basically you can't feel it or anything like that, but when you press down on it, your skin does turn white. Again, the best thing to do is put lots of aloe on that. And sometimes if you can put the aloe in the fridge, it's a little bit more soothing on the skin. You know, ultimately, the absolute best thing is to avoid this. So, you know, we always recommend sunscreen, 30 SPF and above, sun protective clothing, things like that. Sometimes, you know, a little aspirin or ibuprofen or something like that can also help relieve some of the symptoms.
And how do we know if we have sun poisoning?
So sun poisoning, the term is basically, it's like a very severe sunburn. That's when you feel extremely sick after being in the sun. And then you can also almost feel like you have like flu-like symptoms and develop blisters as well too. This could be a little bit more serious because you can become fluid depleted. You know, if you have uncontrollable fevers, chills, nausea, things like that with a severe sunburn, sometimes you even have to go to the hospital or call your doctor or something for that as well. Again, you know, stay out of the sun, drink as many fluids as possible, and use a lot of that aloe.
And when is it time for us to go see a doctor if we're experiencing one of these things?
In terms of heat rash, when you have that rash, if it's really itchy and interfering with your life, not going away after you've taken yourself out of that hot environment, definitely make an appointment with your dermatologist. Sometimes we can prescribe like topical steroids to help relieve the symptoms. Or also if this rash becomes chronic, that way we can rule out any other disease processes as well too. In terms of sunburn, a mild one usually fades within a few days. But if it's very severe, you have blisters or anything like that, it would definitely be good to get checked out as well.
And since we have you here, what's the best? Do you have a suggestion for sunblock?
So I always tell my patients anything 30 SPF and above, so broad spectrum. I myself use mineral-based sunscreens, so zinc and titanium. I love Neutrogena Sheer Zinc. At our office, we have Elta MD as well too, UV Physical, which is one of my favorites as well.
All right, Katie, thanks so much for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. Have a good day. Bye.
You too.